My colleagues, good morning. The topic today is about cholera, and now we will speak about etiology, pathogenesis, epidemiology, clinic, diagnostic, prophylactic, and treatment of cholera. In 1961 began the 7th pandemic of cholera, and the main infection agent is Vibrio eltor, it is serovar of Vibrio of cholera. And Vibrio eltor spread in different countries, continents, spread to Europe, America, Australia, Africa, Asia. You see on the picture Vibrio of cholera, and there are two variants of Vibrions: classic Vibrions and Vibrions eltor. There are some serogroups of Vibrio of cholera. The first serogroups, O1, and serogroup O139, it causes the cholera-like syndrome. Vibrio of cholera, classic Vibrio of cholera, spread in India, Pakistan, Bangladesh. Vibrio eltor spread in Indonesia, Thailand, South Asia, and in 1961 pandemia of cholera caused by Vibrio eltor. Let's speak about etiology, bacteria, what the structure of Vibrio of cholera. You know, Vibrio of cholera synthesis endotoxin consists of endotoxin, it is lipopolysaccharide of Vibrio, and it excretion exotoxin cholerogen, which cause main mechanism of pathogenesis of cholera. Those exotoxin activate of membranes of enterocytes and glandular cells, and activation of mechanism of secretions, secretory mechanism, and it cause activate the clinic of infection. Next, permeability factors. It is factors which activate mechanism of activity of endotoxins and exotoxin cholerogen. Mechanism of transmission is oral mechanism. Main ways of transmission: water, contact, alimentary. And factors of transmissions is water, dirty hands, and foods. Let's speak about pathogenesis of cholera. And you know that oral mechanism of transmission, when vibrions penetrate to stomach, and in the stomach vibrions are destructed because gastric juice and secretory immunoglobulins cause the destruction of vibrions. So increasing of endotoxin in the stomach and penetration to blood. So next, some of vibrions penetrate to small intestinal, and in small intestinal synthesis of exotoxin cholerogen. Synthesis exotoxin cholerogen, which activate mechanism of secretion of intestinal and in the stomach. Because those exotoxins activate the receptor of enterocytes, activate the receptor of glandular cells, and enterocytes and glandular cells begin secretion water in soil to small intestinal. So it caused the formation of syndrome of enteritis, syndrome of diarrhea. At the first stool has character of feces, watery feces, and then it's characterized by rice water stool. Rice water stool. It caused the progressive syndrome of enteritis, massive enteritis, then gastroenteritis, and it caused the syndrome of dehydration, hypovolemia, and formation of dehydratory shock. It is massive dehydration and marked dehydration, and it causes the marked edema concentration, formation of thrombosis of blood vessels, disturbances of microcirculation, metabolic disorders, polyorgans insufficiency, cardiovascular insufficiency, renal insufficiency, thrombosis of blood vessels, because formation thrombosis in different blood vessels, more often in mesenterical blood vessels, formation of ischemia of intestinal, necrosis of intestinal. Sometimes other symbolic complications. It caused the polyorgans insufficiency, metabolic disorders, and death of the patients. And examination of the patients, we indication some markers of cholera, for example, mask of Hippocrates, pose of boxer, pose of fighter, pose of gladiator. So such clinical symptoms characterize syndrome of dehydration in the patients with cholera. Sometimes during progressive of polyorgans insufficiency, activation of secondary infection, for example, formation of pneumonia, cholangitis, enteritis, and others focus of infection. What morphological results in cholera, the causes of death of the patients is dehydration, thrombosis of blood vessels, disturbances of microcirculation, polyorgans insufficiency. So there is no intoxication, there is no toxic shock, only syndrome of dehydration. Because morphological results, for example, degeneration of the liver, degeneration of kidney, myocardial dystrophia, dystrophia of the kidney, thrombosis of blood vessels. And morphological examination, we indication the blood like urine jelly, blood like urine jelly, watch a woman hand, cholera skin fold. So let's speak about the clinic of cholera. Now we see that there is cyclic process in clinical symptoms. At first, period of incubation. Period of incubation lasts some days, from 1 up to 2 days. Next, prodromal period, because sometimes a little syndrome of intoxication and the toxinemia may be in those patients. Sometimes those syndrome may be absent, but sometimes prodromal period lasts 3-4 days and it's characterized by asthenic syndrome, maybe asthenia, insomnia, general malaise, sometimes subfebrility temperature. Next period, period of main clinical syndromes when manifestation of watery diarrhea. At first, diarrhea has a feces character, Then it formation rice-water stool. Rice-water stool, syndrome of enteritis, then syndrome of gastritis, formation vomiting. And character of vomiting is rice-water too. So progressive of dehydration cause progressive of gastroenteritis, formation syndrome of dehydration. So syndrome of dehydration characterize such clinical symptoms. First, decreasing of turgor of skin, tonic cramps, pose of boxer, pose of gladiator, at the severe forms, decreasing of arterial blood pressure, decreasing of diuresis, polyorgans insufficiency, hemoconcentration, increasing of hematocrit, blood viscosity. So, we indication for stage of dehydration. So, just classification of cholera characterized by four stage of dehydration. The first and second stage, it is mild and moderate forms of cholera. Third and fourth stage of dehydration characterize severe forms of cholera and complication with absorption those stage of infection. So let's speak about those stage. Now we characterize those stage and characterize main clinical symptoms. So the first stage of dehydration characterized by such moments, the patient loses from 1 up to 3% of water, of mass of patient, and it is mild forms of cholera. It's characterized by diarrhea no more than 10 times per day. It is diarrhea is characterized by feces character, maybe water stool, no more than the 10 times per day. There is not marked dehydration, sometimes indication thirsty and decreasing of turgor of skin. Second stage of dehydration, when patient loses from 4 up to 6%, it is the phase of compensation of dehydratory shock, and it is moderate forms, and it's characterized by stool more than 10 times per day, manifestation of vomiting, gastroenteritis, rice water stool, moderate dehydration characterized by thirsty, decreasing of turgor of skin, sometimes tonic cramps, sometimes tonic cramps. Next, third stage of dehydration, patient loses from 7 up to 9% of mass of patient. It is second stage of dehydratory shock. It is stage of subcompensation of dehydratory shock. And clinic of the stage is thirsty, decreasing of turgor of skin. Maybe tonic cramps. Tonic cramps, massive tonic cramps, pose of boxer, pose of gladiator, aphonia, decreasing of arterial blood pressure, decreasing of diuresis. And next, polyorgans insufficiency formation in the those stage. Fourth stage of dehydration, it is terminal stage of dehydratory shock. It is third stage of decompensation of dehydratory shock when patient loses more than 10% of mass. and it is terminal conditions of the patients, and in those patients we can observe face of Hippocrates, pose of boxer, pose of gladiator, massive tonic cramps, anuria, loss of arterial blood pressure, loss of consciousness, diffusion cyanosis. So it is terminal conditions of the patients. So they are for stage of dehydration, and those stage characterize the different forms of cholera. And we spoke that the first and second stage, it is mild and moderate forms of cholera. Third and fourth stage is severe forms of cholera. And fourth stage of dehydration, it is cholericalgite. Yes, it is cholericalgite when patient lose more than 10% of mass of patient. And in the third and fourth stage of dehydration, we indication massive tonic cramps, pose of boxer, pose of gladiator. We indication watch a woman hand, cholera skin fold, face of Hippocrates. Cardiovascular insufficiency, decreasing of diuresis, polyorgans insufficiency, dyspnea, diffusion cyanosis. Now we continue characterize the stage of dehydration. So not only clinical characteristic, but laboratory characteristic stage of dehydration. For example, what there is on those picture, a laboratory characteristic of stage of dehydration. For example, third stage of dehydration, when a patient lose from 1 up to 3%, we indication hematocrit is interval 0.45 up to 0.50. Blood viscosity is less than 1026. Second stage of dehydration, when patient lose from 4 up to 6%, hematocrit is interval 0.45 and 0.50. Blood viscosity is interval 1026 and 1029. It is a phase compensation of the dehydratory shock. Stage number 3, patient lose from 7 up to 9%. Hematocrit is interval 0.50 and 0.55. And blood viscosity 1030 and 1035. So third stage is stage of subcompensation of dehydratory shock. And fourth stage of dehydration formation of terminal conditions of the patients. It is cholericalgite. Patient lose more than 10% of mass of patient, and hematocrit is more than 0.55. And hematocrit is more, so blood viscosity is more than 1035. So we see progressive of gamma concentration, increasing of blood viscosity, hematocrit. So, and it called the formation of thrombosis, of microthrombosis of blood vessels, and it caused such complications of cholera. So in the patient, we indication increasing of urea and creatinine in blood because it is a formation of renal insufficiency, respiratory insufficiency, renal insufficiency, cardiovascular insufficiency. So, and complication of cholera is dehydratory shock, vascular thrombosis, for example, ischemia of intestinal, formation of necrosis of intestinal. Next, activation of secondary infection, for example, formation of pneumonia. Secondary pneumonia, progressive of respiratory insufficiency, dyspnea, and formation of infiltration in the lung. You see the picture, the pose of boxer. Yes, the pose of boxer, which characterizes the tonic cramps in the patients with cholera, tonic cramps, massive tonic cramps in third and fourth stage of infection. Next, mask of Hippocratic, face of Hippocratic, mask of Hippocratic. Mask of Hippocratic. Symptoms of dark glasses. Dark glasses. Decreasing of turgor of skin. Yes, on the third and fourth stage of dehydration. Cholera skin fold. Cholera skin fold. Yes, watch woman hands, watch woman hands. On the third and fourth stage of the dehydration. Convulsions, tonic convulsions of hands, obstetrician hand. On the third and fourth stage of dehydration, obstetrician hand. It's characterized by severe dehydration and tonic convulsions. Tonic convulsions in the patients. The severe forms of cholera, it's characterized by formation of tonic convulsions, then clonic convulsions. It's characterized by severe dehydration. Those patients, mass differentiation with different disease, for example, neurological disease, endocrinological disorders, for example. For example, obstetrician hand may be in different endocrinological disorders, and in neurological syndrome in different neurological disease, and for example, destruction of central nervous system, differentiation with tetanus, for example, epistatonus and tetanic convulsions, tetanic cramps, tetanus, tetanic cramps in and epistatonus. Differentiation with others, infection which characterized by such clinical symptoms. Cholera with differentiation with other intestinal infection, for example, salmonellosis, It's characterized by increasing of the temperature, syndrome of gastroenteritis, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, increasing of the temperature. Yes, and we know dominate in salmonellosis the fever and gastroenteritis. And we know that in cholera there is no high fever, there is no intoxication, and at first manifestation syndrome of enteritis. In salmonellosis we observe the yellow-green stool, watery stool, green-yellow watery stool. And in cholera stool is rice water stool, rice water character. Next, with differentiation with shigellosis, dysenteria, and you know the main clinical symptoms is in shigellosis in syndrome of colitis. And it's characterized by increasing of the temperature, syndrome of colitis, the stool, the diarrhea with the mucus admixtures and blood admixtures, tenesmus, abdominal pain, rectal pain, tenesmus, so spasm of sigma region. So we observe in dysenteria, in colitic forms of dysenteria. Fever, intoxication, two the indication in dysenteria. Next we differentiation cholera and escherichiosis. Escherichiosis enterohemorrhagical and enterotoxigenic escherichiosis. Enterohemorrhagical escherichiosis characterized by increasing of the temperature, sometimes subfebrility temperature, then increasing temperature and formation of diarrhea with blood admixtures, massive blood admixtures, hemorrhagical enterocolitis and formation of uremic syndrome and hemorrhagical syndrome. Infection agent is Escherichia coli, enterohemorrhagical Escherichia coli. Formation of severe forms of hemorrhagical colitis. So with differentiation cholera and for example enterotoxigenic escherichiosis, infection agent is Escherichia, enterotoxigenic serovar, stem of Escherichia coli, cause the choleric-like syndrome. And formation of diarrhea, rice water stool, syndrome of enteritis, and gastroenteritis. But those escherichiosis, enterotoxigenic escherichiosis, characterized by mild and moderate forms. There is no marked dehydration in those infection. There is no dehydratory shock in escherichiosis. Next, cholera with diffusion with the poisoning of mushrooms, and it's characterized by profuse diarrhea, dehydration, marked severe forms of gastroenteritis, formation of dehydratory syndrome, but in poisoning of mushroom formation, liver insufficiency and renal insufficiency. So in those patient formation syndrome of jaundice, it is parenchyma jaundice, increasing of transaminase, uremic syndrome, increasing of urea and creatinine in blood, formation of liver and renal insufficiency. Now, cholera with infection with severe forms rotaviral infection, and we spoke about rotaviral infection, and so infection agent is rotavirus with oral and respiratory mechanism of transmission, And so rotavirus penetrate to intestinal system and replication to epithelium of gastrointestinal system. So, and it causes the formation of watery diarrhea, osmotic diarrhea. So it is activation of secretory mechanism of diarrhea and formation of enteritis, gastroenteritis, sometimes dehydration, but there is no severe dehydration. There is no dehydratory shock in rotaviral infection. And in rotaviral infection, we indication Kercherl syndrome, for example. It is a formation of Kercherl syndrome, rhinitis, pharyngitis, gravity of forces, sore throat, increasing of lymphatic nodes. Cholera with infestation with tetanus, yes, tetanus, formation of opisthotonus in the patient, and tetanic cramps, clonic cramps. Uremic gastroenteritis characterized by metabolic disorders in clinic of renal insufficiency. It may be hemorrhagical fever with renal syndrome when formation uremic syndrome, uremic gastroenteritis, tonic cramps, encephalopathia, hemorrhagical syndrome. Or in, for example, severe concomitant disorders, for example, chronic nephritis, chronic amyloidosis of the renins, and formation of uremic syndrome, which characterize nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, syndrome of gastroenteritis, and increasing of urea and creatinine in blood. Next, we differentiation with necrosis of pancreas, pancreanecrosis, which characterized by nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, dehydration, abdominal pain, and increasing of the temperature. We must remember that in cholera there is no fever, there is no intoxication, and manifestation of infection characterized by syndrome of enteritis. At first, stool has a feces character, watery stool, feces stool, and then it transformates to rice water stool, and then formation of syndrome of gastritis and vomiting characterized by rice water too, and syndrome of enteritis and gastroenteritis cause the formation of dehydratory syndrome and formation of dehydratory shock, polyorgans insufficiency, and death of the patients. And it characterizes tonic cramps, so characterize such clinic, for example, pose of boxer, pose of gladiator, skin fold, watch a woman hands, decreasing of turgor of skin, mask of Hippocrate, so such clinical syndrome. Let's speak about diagnostic of cholera. What main moment we must remember for diagnostic? We must know anamnesis of the patients, contact of the patients, characteristic of life, anamnesis of life of the patients. More often the patients with cholera is asocial patients. So in anamnesis, migration from different country, contact of the patients. So it is very important to diagnostic of infection. But main moments for diagnostic is laboratory examinations, laboratory tests, and main methods of examinations is bacteriological methods, when we indication bacteriological test. Copra culture, yes, feces culture on one peptones water, form number 30, yes, it is forms of dangerous infection, conventions infection. All the patients with severe forms intestinal infection may be salmonellosis, shigellosis, escherichiosis, yersiniosis. So all severe forms of intestinal infection, we must examine those patients on cholera, on form number 30. It is copra culture on warm peptone water. Next test is a serological test when we indication reaction of non-direct deagglutination. Yes, it we indication main serovar of cholera, Anaba, Inaba, Gikashima. We indication serogroups of vibrion of cholera, Agava, Inaba, Gikashima. And next reaction of immobilization and microagglutination with anticholeric serum. With anticholeric serum, it is express diagnostic of cholera. Reaction of immobilization and microagglutination with anticholeric serum. Also, we must administer the patient's indication gematocrit, yes, blood viscosity, level of urea creatinine in blood. So it is characteristic of gamma concentration and characteristic of polyorgans insufficiency, renal insufficiency in the patients. Let's about treatments of the patients with cholera. If the patients with third and fourth stage of the dehydration, it is severe forms of infection, stage of subcompensation and decompensation of the dehydratory shock. At first, we administer primary rehydration. The aim of primary rehydration is stabilization of hemodynamic and diuresis. And we continue infusion therapy for stabilization of hemodynamic and diuresis. The introduction crystalloids, polyons solutions, crystalloids, salt solutions. Квартосоль, хлорсоль, лактосоль. Rapid of infusion from 100 up to 120 milliliters per minute. The temperature of solutions from 31 up to 39 or 38 up to 39 degrees. Continue infusion with so rapid 100 milliliter per minute, only 2-3 liter, and then we decreasing rapid of infusion. Decreasing rapid of infusion after 2 or 3 liter. And then rapid of infusion is from 40 up to 60 milliliter per minute. It is average rapid of infusion. So it is primary rehydration. For example, volume of the dehydration, for example, in third stage of the dehydration, nearby 4 or 5 liters. It is a massive infusion of the patients. And we have a formula when we indicate the volume of infusion. Yes, and nearby it is volume is 4 or 5 liters. It is initial primary regeneration. So when stabilization of hemodynamic and formation of diuresis of the patient, we finish primary regeneration. And next phase, it is correction, connection regeneration. Next phase is correction or connection regeneration. So it is correction of syndrome of dehydration, because patient continue lose water and salt, and also those time we continue correction regeneration. The volume of correction regeneration depends of loss of the patient. Nearby 1 liter per day or 2 liter per day, for example. Yes, so we indicate the volume of stool, and so we indicate the volume of infusion therapy. So you see the salts and crystalloids, which includes to those solution. For example, quartasol consists of such ions. For example, sodium chloride, sodium acetate, sodium bicarbonate, potassium chloride. So such components includes crystalloid solutions. Sometimes we continue correction regeneration, but we must remember that cholera is conventions disease, and we must administer etiological treatment, antibiotic treatment. Yes, so main antibiotic treatment is tetracycline or doxycycline. For example, dose of tetracycline 0.3 for time per day during 5 days. Sometimes we can administer doxycycline, for example, 100 milligram 2 times per day during 5 days. Sometimes we can administer quinolones, fluoroquinolones, cifran or ciprofloxacin. Dose of ciprofloxacin 500 milligram 2 times per day. So we must remember about basic therapy. In mild and moderate forms of cholera, we administer oral regidratation, regidron, citroglucosalan. It is solutions for oral regidratation, which consists of natrium chloride, natrium hydrocarbonate, and glucose. 1 or 2 liters per day. Enterosorbents. Enterodes, Polifipan, Titoprotecta, Smecta, for example, Enteros gel during some days for stabilization of function of intestinal. You see, in mild to moderate forms, oral regidratation, regidron, citroglucosaline, the diets, exclusion spicy, fatty products, diets products. So, control, bacteriological test, yes, after clinical recovery, and after finish of antibiotic treatments, we administer control bacteriological test. 3 negative results after ending of antibiotic treatments. Fecal culture, of cholera 3 days after the end of antibiotic treatments. We can have 3 negative results. Only in those situations we can discharge patients from hospital. If the patient is with asymptomatic subclinical forms of cholera, when there is no clinic, there is no symptoms of infection, but we have a positive test on cholera, we have a bacteriological test of cholera, we can administer tetracycline or doxycycline. Tetracycline 0.3 gram 3 times during 4 days. Then control bacteriological test after 3 days after ending of antibiotic treatments. So we have 3 negative bacteriological results. You see on the picture hospital of cholera in Africa, you see the system of rehydration. Infusion rehydration. Yes, there is vaccination of cholera. Yes, there are many methods of prevention of cholera. It is quarantine, isolation of the patients, diagnostic and isolation patients and carers of cholera, treatments of cholera and treatments the patients and carers of vibrions of cholera. And prevention, preventive treatments of contact persons. So all contact patients can use antibiotics, for example, tetracycline or doxycycline during 5 days. Then methods of disinfection and methods of vaccination, group of risk. For example, what about group of risk? It is contact groups. It is doctors, nurses, it is travelings, and the patient who live in endemic region of cholera. For example, in Africa, India, in a social and a social group of population. Because there is capuscular vaccine, anticholeric vaccine, and then revaccination after year, if they have a risk infection. My colleagues, thank you for your time. The lecture is over.